we're interviewing Jack Hebert. He's the American Advertising Federation 4th District's lobbyist, and we want to talk to him a little bit more about the amendment. Jack, we kind of know a little bit about what's going on with the amendment, but we're hoping that you can give us a little bit more details and kind of explain it in layman's terms to us.
Sure, we can roll forward a little bit from the senator's interview because there have been some late-breaking developments, in fact, as late as today. I don't think the senator mentioned, but a circuit judge, a coalition, took this before into court, trying to have it thrown off the ballot, including a lot of the opponents of it, obviously. And Circuit Judge Cooper in Tallahassee ruled that it be thrown off the ballot. This happened about 2 weeks ago. Mm-hmm. So since that time has passed, we are now in an appeals process. The Supreme Court, the Florida Supreme Court, has accepted jurisdiction and has agreed to go ahead and hear the appeal on an expedited basis. Originally, they'd set the oral arguments for September 8th on Monday, and this afternoon they decided to speed it up, and they've rescheduled now for next Wednesday, the 3rd.
Oh, wow.
They will hear it instead. There is obviously an interest to get this decided now that the primary election from yesterday is over, so that the supervisors in all 67 counties can get ballots out so that, you know, people have a chance to see actually what they're voting on and whether Amendment 5 stays or not. So as it stands now, we're not on the ballot. That could very well change after the Supreme Court makes its decision.
So as the American Advertising Federation's 4th District lobbyist, you're, I take it, up there in Tallahassee lobbying for us. Could you tell us a little bit more about that?
Well, I like to use an expression that Congressman Feeney used. I stole from him when he spoke to a group explaining what a lobbyist. The lobbyist is the person you have to hire to protect you from the people you elect to office. So in a roundabout way, I guess that's what I do, but I'm really kind of the voice of the advertising industry in front of elected officials in this state, primarily obviously in the state legislature, and also a coalition partner with the other lobbyists that represent the various facets of our industry, the outdoor advertisers, the Printers Association, film, video, tourism, economic, you know, those partners that we have. So it's kind of a collective effort in terms of, you know, the advertising industry here in Florida, which is a big business.
So your lobbying efforts have a lot to do with, and the reason that you're involved in that has a lot to do with the impact that it could have on the advertising industry.
Correct.
But I understand we're not the only ones that would be affected by this. Can you talk a little bit about
that's a very good
how this would affect the rest of the business climate?
That's a good point, because we do, you know, part of our message, part of my message is that advertising, you know, fuels Florida's economy.
Sure.
I mean, without advertising, you know, everything comes to a screeching halt. And in fact, as most of us know, when things slow down like this, like the economy we're in right now, you know, those of us on the agency side say what you need to do is advertise more, not less, which is a tough decision. But that is generally the right decision in many circumstances to get things going. So it is a terrific engine. AAF, our parent, American Advertising Federation, commissioned a study with Global Insight a couple years ago looking at the effect of taxing advertising and what it meant. And their forecast is that just a 6% increase, a sales tax on advertising, say in the state, would cost the state immediately 90,000 jobs and over $1 billion in lost sales. And the trickle down from that obviously would be huge.
Are those 90,000 jobs in the ad industry, or are those?
No, we're talking about across the whole, you know, fabric of the industry to start with.
Sure.
I mean, it would just start, so it is.
And certainly
huge.
A large percentage of those would be advertising.
Obviously, there would be. We know that from, as the senator pointed out on tape in 1987, we know exactly what happened. Agencies left the state, media buys moved outside of the state, magazines came into the state with blank pages. TV screens rolled with 30-second blank spots.
Crazy.
I mean, in the middle, it was pretty bizarre.
Wow.
Nothing we'd like to relive.
No. So, inevitably, we won't be the only state that faces a service tax or something similar to this. As being part of the American Advertising Federation, we're being part of a huge organization that fights these type of legislative issues across the country.
Yes.
Do you have any advice for other states that might be facing this now or potentially face this in the
future?
Well,
interestingly, since the 1987, what I call the weird science experiment that we did here in Florida, about half or so of the other states have tried a services tax in some form or shape, not just on advertising, but on services.
Wow.
hadn't worked well almost any place, and most, without exception, have repealed those taxes.
Really?
Now, the most recent experiment was Michigan, who was having budget woes not 6 months ago, and decided a good way to plug their budget problems would be a services tax, and it started to encroach on some advertising aspects, and it's already turned into a nightmare.
They actually went ahead and implemented that?
They are trying to do a limited services tax and on a few components of advertising to try and fill a budget shortfall that they're experiencing there. It is not going well. So my advice to any other state was be very careful before you head down this path. Take a look at what happened, not only here, but around the country.
And make sure you have a lobbyist in place, too.
Make sure you have a lobbyist in place, yes.
Now,
always.
As you said, obviously the downfall of the service tax, we've certainly heard that those could be monumental and very negative for our industry and for the economy as a whole. But is that necessarily what Amendment 5 would do, or what are some of the other?
No,
is
that,
there another possibility?
That's a good point, because the amendment doesn't say that. The amendment doesn't direct the legislature to go there. What the amendment does is doesn't really tell you much of anything. That's part of the problem, and part of what Senator Crist was referring to. It gives the legislature the option of maybe raising the sales tax a cent. It gives them the possibility of making budget adjustments because of economic growth, which we know a whole lot of that's not going on right now in Florida, but that's another story. It gives them the option of doing anything else that's available to them. So we launch into this voting for this, not clear where it's going to go. I mean, it really is a proverbial train wreck headed down a track. When you go in and say yes or no, if you say yes, you don't know where it's going to end up.
Yeah.
That could be a 1 cent sales tax, 2 cent. It could be ultimately a personal income tax. It could be any of a myriad of things. And so we don't know. It's just if you look at the numbers and you add up and what people say, oh, if we take away a few sales tax exemptions like ostrich feed and skyboxes and all those, we'll be able to plug the gap. You can't get the numbers to add up to do that without looking for some pretty creative funding streams.
Now, I have a question that kind of it would impact me personally, being a young
sure.
professional. Would this service tax, since the benefits of it would be property tax decrease and it cuts a lot of jobs, is there any extra downsides for young professionals that you could see?
Well, I can see one immediately. This is not tax relief for a renter. So, I mean, I look back when I was a young advertising person coming out of college, and I rented, you know, an apartment for 2 years and a house for a couple years until I could get a down payment. There's no tax relief there for you. Now, for the apartment complex owner, there may be, or they will be, and I'm sure that in their munificence they will pass that on to you.
Sure.
Maybe not. So, no, there isn't. But every time you go to pick up your dry cleaning, get your hair styled, do a variety of things or whatever, you're going to be paying another 7%. So it's going to hit you harder than the average Floridian, who at least is getting a little bit break on the other side. So for a young professional, probably not the smartest thing to do. And even the economists that the Taxation Budget Reform Commission listened to said that was the case, that it was, you know, going to disproportionately hit, you know, younger people that didn't own property harder than the others.
Well, Jack, thanks for joining us on the
show. Thank you.
If I can just get one final question out of you, it would be, as the average voter, what can we do?
Well, I think a couple things. Spread the word. I mean, to other people that this is, you know, the pig in a poke, bait and switch, a wolf in sheep's clothing, whatever metaphor you want to use, because that's what it is. It looks really handsome and it looks really attractive. I know more than anybody, and anybody in business in Florida, like those that will follow, like Glenn Peak, that property owners in Florida need tax relief. There's no question about it. Particularly in this economy, businesses need some help there. And it's very attractive to go ahead and do that. But the catch-22, it's going to catch up with you, and you're going to more than pay for that. So just be very careful. Like the senator said, read, study, and know what you're doing before you go in there and vote. But be sure to vote.
Great advice always.
Yeah. Thanks so much, Jack. It's
Thank
been
you,
great
Kate.
Having
Thank
you.
You
on.
Good to be with you.
And
Thanks.
As always, we want to thank our sponsors, TBT, Tampa Digital Studios, and Spark for hosting us tonight on location.
And thanks to you at home for watching. We'll be back in just a couple minutes.